So, Wonder Woman 1984 or Wonder Woman 84 is out. Yo, Wash Chu, where's the trailer for Godzilla vs. Kong? Yo, Wash Chu, you were wrong. You lied. Yo, Wash Chu, what's going on with the trailer? Okay, guys, I hear ya. I see your comments. I can't reply to all of them. So, let's go on. Let's go over what's happening with it. So, yo, what is good, YouTube? Wash Chu here with a video on Godzilla vs. Kong. Where is the trailer? What is happening? So, if you are new around here, make sure to subscribe to never miss any of the videos. At the 100,000 subscribe mark, I will be giving away something that is so damn hard to get a hold of. You can't even get a hold of it, even if you got the money. So, check us out on Instagram at WushChu, Twitter, WushChuG. Right, let's get back to the video. So, Godzilla vs. Kong, it's in disarray, kind of. So, we're less than 6 months away till the movie, but we've got no official trailer. We've got 2 seconds at CCXP 2019. And we've got 2 to 3 seconds at CCXP 2020, where we see King Kong, sorry for legal issues, we're not allowed to call him King Kong. We've got Kong in chains because he's being teleported, transported from one monarch place to the next. And then you see Godzilla underwater. So under 6 months to go, no official trailer. What is happening? Legendary Pictures sent legal documents to Warner Bros. Because they do not want Godzilla vs. Kong 2020 going straight to a streaming service because it makes no sense. So, watching Wonder Woman 1984 in person, you have to watch movies at the theaters. I know what you guys are going to say, it's not safe, but guys, it really is. I've watched a bunch of movies there. It really is safe to go to the cinema. You do not have a screen that is as good as a cinema screen at your house. Even if you got an £8,000 OLED 8K TV, you still haven't. The surround sound you got in your house is not as good and it's not as powerful as what you have at a cinema. Godzilla vs. Kong has to be seen on an IMAX big ass screen. So the most logical place to stick the trailer would be with Wonder Woman 1984. Why? Because that's also a Warner Bros. Property. Everyone loves Gal Gadot, everyone loves Wonder Woman, so stick it with that. So the only thing I can imagine now is the Godzilla vs. Kong trailer is going to be coming out on HBO Max on the 25th of December, Christmas Day, alongside Wonder Woman 1984 on HBO Max on streaming. I mean, I'm not saying it's going to happen, but that makes the most logical sense. I was wrong that it didn't release a Wonder Woman, but I always put a disclaimer that everything I say might not come true. This is just theorizing. I've spoke to insiders and they kind of agree as well that it makes logical sense to come out of Wonder Woman 1984. Now, if this isn't the case, then they're going to drop it randomly sometime in January. Maybe this legal issue that may be coming up with, obviously, Legendary Pictures suing Warner Bros. Or AT&T, it's looking that way. Obviously, Legendary Pictures has, you know, shareholders, has investors. They invested 75% of this movie. They made the movie. Warner Bros. Studios is just the distributor. They're the distributor, so to speak. So, realistically, they can't do this without Legendary Pictures' permission. They've also done the same thing with a Dune movie that should have come out. Like, this movie's been ready to go for such a long time. This movie should have came out already. So it's delayed by 6 months. It's coming out in May. So under 6 months to go, no trailer. What is going on? Guys, chill. It is not my fault. I'm just doing updated trailer videos because you guys keep asking. So I went there to watch Wonder Woman 1984, hoping to see the Godzilla vs. Kong trailer so I could inform you guys what's happening. I thought they'd drop it on, obviously, the cinema first, then I thought it would drop into YouTube a week or so after, like has happened with so many other movies where it goes to cinema exclusively. The only thing I can think of is because most cinemas in America are closed, and that's maybe why I've done it. But most cinemas in the UK up till today, as the time of recording this video on Saturday, were open. Now, I know a lot of places have gone to like tier 3 in the UK, which means cinemas can't open, but there is still a lot of places that are tier 2 where you can go to the theatres. So go to theatres if you can. So an update video, guys, is also apparently, I've been told, I don't know how verified or true this is, apparently there's something called HBO Max Fandom, which if you sign up to is going to give you access to the trailer for Godzilla vs. Kong and HBO Max. But if that's the case, then it's still going to HBO Max anyway alongside, you know, with Wonder Woman 1984. So likewise, guys, this is an updated video. Where is the trailer? I want to see it. We are less than 6 months to this movie. It's coming out. I really hope Legendary Pictures wins their case. Warner Bros. / AT&T. And we get the trailer to hit soon. But more Exactly. We get this movie to only come out in the theaters and then go to streaming services after. It makes literally no sense to reject Netflix's offer and then drop it on HBO Max, because HBO Max at the moment is in disarray. There's literally no content. This is why Warner Bros. Has thrown their complete cinematic theatrical release straight on to HBO Max, because there's literally nothing on HBO Max. I'm as frustrated and as annoyed as you guys are, because it makes absolutely no sense at CCXP not to give us the full trailer and give us a 2-second tease. What is going on? Maybe spam, or maybe ask Adam Wingard, the director, yo, what is good YouTube, and say, yo, where's the trailer? It makes literally no sense. So I'm just like trying to keep the MonsterVerse community going with these videos. I understand there's other MonsterVerse videos that do a lot of content. I'm just saying, yo, where is this trailer? If this trailer does not come out Christmas Day alongside Wonder Woman 1984, which is going to obviously give HBO Max a lot of traffic on Christmas Day, Boxing Day, New Year's Day, and all this kind of stuff, probably a lot of traffic for the next like week or so after it drops on the 25th of December, then I don't know what to say. If it doesn't come 25th of December, there is no trailer. The movie's never come in. It's been delayed like 4 times. Yo, what is going on? So like always, guys, we are doing a competition at 100,000 subscriber mark. It's just to say thank you to you guys subscribing. So what you got to do is subscribe to the channel with notifications on and let me know down below what is going on with Godzilla versus Kong. And also let me know all your conspiracy theories, all your theories about the movie. Am I wrong about what I've been told? Careful, spoilers, I don't want to ruin your life. Am I wrong about what I've been told about Godzilla winning? Slightly. And then obviously them getting into a fight, then Godzilla slightly wins, and then Mechagodzilla comes through, and then what happens after that is obviously Kong recovers, and then he helps Godzilla, and then it's Godzilla versus Kong, and then they start punching Mechagodzilla, and then they take out Mechagodzilla, and it's kind of a Batman versus Superman situation. But Adam Wingard, the director, said there's an actual clear winner, but my sources have told me there isn't a clear winner. There's a winner, but not a clear winner. Anyone walking to this movie thinking that one of these monsters is going to be killed, nah, it's not happening. They've got so much potential with the MonsterVerse, but in my opinion, they've got to keep these movies at the theaters for theatrical releases and keep it off streaming. Do streaming like, I don't know, 3 months or so after. So guys, let me know your conspiracy theories for Godzilla vs. Kong. I know we'll catch you in another video, but like I said, guys, check us out on twitch.tv/WarStew. I've been streaming Cyberpunk 2077 quite a lot on there. Also, check us out on Instagram @WarStew. Do stories literally all day long. And Twitter, WarStewG. I'm trying to hit 2,000 followers, which is really low for a channel this size. So like always, guys, I'll catch you in another video very soon. Catch ya later.